Mars 2020 rover.
I won't be able to go to the launch because of the current pandemic stuff. So that's something that I'm disappointed in that I can't do, but I'm super excited about landing. That's in February. And that's what I've been working on for the last 7 years. NASA Langley has a very critical role as part of the entry, descent, and landing team. That's the phase of flight where we've been in space for many months and we're going to hit the top of the atmosphere on Mars, and we have to decelerate all the way down to 0 meters per second so that we can land safely. So some of the only ways we can simulate Mars is on a computer, so on a simulation. So that's kind of where I come in. July 4th, 1997 was when the first rover on Mars landed, Mars Pathfinder. And I didn't work on it. I was in middle school at that time. And in fact, I was in middle school in India at that time. But I remember seeing pictures, you know, in the great early days of internet coming in from Mars. And it just inspired me so much to go into aerospace engineering. And it's weird that here, 23 years later, I'm going to work on the next rover that's going to land on Mars. So I've been pretty lucky in the 7 years that I've worked here at NASA Langley that I have been able to work on Mars 2020 basically from the start, and even some offshoot projects of Mars 2020. So one project was a mission called Aspire, which was a series of sounding rocket tests that happened at Wallops Island a couple of years ago. We basically had three tests to test out the Mars 2020 parachute. And we really just wanted to understand the dynamics of these Mars parachutes that open supersonically. They open at almost 2 times the speed of sound. So, you know, it's a pretty dynamic environment there. Check back with us in the future as you hear how NASA Langley contributed to the entry, descent, and landing in other ways.